try that again. Hello and welcome. My name is Elizabar, and this is Condor. I was just adjusting the volume a little bit. I have no idea what the volume's going to sound like once we get in the game. But we're going to give this a try. So there's text on the webpage for this on itch.io. Condor, you are tasked with hacking data nodes throughout Neo Cusco. Just get close enough and our team will do the rest remotely. Proceed to the top of the spire to complete your assignment. This is important. Other teams are running diversionary acts of cyber terrorism, so you should not encounter any resistance. Oh, hey, I can mouse outside the window. That's terrible. You should not encounter any resistance. You are a valued employee. Praying Mantis. Ow. Okay, I am a light source. So, controls, let's see. Hey! Okay, I'm disoriented. There's nothing that way. Oh, this light source that's on me is going to blind me. Cool. So this is kind of a platformy game? Sure beats being a walking simulator, huh? Okay. So where is the spire? Where are checkpoints? They said, yellow light beacons are checkpoints, okay? Well, there's a yellow light. Is that a checkpoint? It's over here. Oh boy, don't look down! Oh my god, agoraphobia was triggered! There's a reason I never got past, like, the second or third stage of Mirror's Edge. Heights do something to me. It's a primal fear. I feel like I'm going completely the wrong way. What's over here? What's over here is I can't go in there. That's what's over here. Alright. I think I'm stuck. Where am I supposed to go? Don't tell me I'm actually supposed to run on those little things, the pipes. That seems crazy to me, and I'm not crazy about it. I think I'm gonna go back this way. Totally a cool looking game. I gotta give it that. This is how high I can jump. Can I jump over here? Some extra height. Oh, we're dead. Goodbye, Condor's dead. Watch the game close itself when this is done. Oh, it didn't. That's a surprise. I'll go the other way. Like, I don't feel like this should be that hard to find my path, but it's that hard to find my path. Yellow beacons or checkpoints? Yeah, well, I haven't seen a yellow beacon yet. Oh. Okay, there was no other way to go, so this is the way to go. Condor. I hit my head on things because it is fun. And that is what Condor is about. Bum, 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 bum. Bum, bum. Well. Alright, we made it up here. Haha! For some reason, I was assuming I couldn't get on these things. Well, Condor is just going to kind of run this way now. So I got the page for the game open right here on my other monitor. Stealth-filled, you're equipped with a prototype harness that will mask your presence to security fields and sensors as long as you stay above a certain altitude. All electromagnetic radiation is turned into visible spectrum light. Well, that's why things look this way. It's certainly a cool look. I like that. But if you've been watching me play any video games, you know I eat up interesting looks, cool visuals. Where am I supposed to go? Guess this way? There's nowhere else to go for me right now. Not from up here. I wish I knew where the spire was. This is featureless. This is the wrong way. I think that arrow's telling me where I want to go, but I don't know how to get to it. Can I just run and jump all the way across this thing, you think? Oh, what about that thing? I missed it. I was looking down. I made a mistake. Oh, we're dead. We're dead. Yep. Goodbye, cruel world. So I bet what I'm supposed to do is over here. And then do that same ledge running thing on these buildings, like this pink one. Yeah, here we go. Very pink. Very bright pink. I don't know if I'm going to be able to beat this game, because I don't know what I'm doing here. Can we just jump across to there? Just hold the jetpack down. Oh my god, we're going to die. We missed it. We're dead. Okay, well, I don't have any good... the thing that's brilliant about Mirror's Edge is if you pay attention to the colors, the game tells you where you're supposed to go. It's rarely a mystery how you're supposed to go from A to B. With this game, I have no conception of how I'm supposed to maneuver around the space. I don't think it's going to be something like, anytime you see pink, that's where you're supposed to go or something. Or go between pink and blue areas. I don't think it works that way. I really feel like these little pipe things are what I'm supposed to be on. Okay, well, I was wrong about that. Hug the wall, hug the wall. Oh my god. Okay. Now from here, we gotta make it over to this building somewhere. Come out, come out. You're almost there, you're almost there. Shoosh. Oh my goodness. Well, I think this game needs more polish. To really be super ultra playable. But did we finally make it to where that yellow sign... No, it's still up there. Where am I supposed to go from here? It's kind of hard to get a look around. I think I can make this jump. If I can't, then this is it. We're done. But I think I can just make a jump over here to this building somewhere. Yeah. All right, we'll keep running. Okay, I want to get to that yellow thing. I think that yellow thing is where I need to go. I didn't expect this to be so dang tricky. I mean, this isn't even where I wanted to go, is it? There's nowhere to go from here. This yellow thing is exactly where I wanted to go. Oh my god, look at that. Here, hop. Oh my god, oh, okay. Controls are, they have that unity looseness that's not so great, but we just made it to our first checkpoint. I wish I was an Aztec or a runner in Peru who built such beautiful buildings to house a chosen few, like an Inca from Peru. Okay, well, that's a nice little poem thing. So like in Mirror's Edge, I would just like tap jump, and I would leap across these things, you know, and not have to worry about how high I'm jetting and things like that. The game would just be like, yeah, you want to parkour? Cool, let's parkour. And we'd be parkouring around, but this is all, oh no, it just feels weird, and it's uncomfortable, and I don't know, maybe that's the agoraphobia, blah, 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 words, maybe it's the words talking. Screw words. I hate words. There's the next node. That's where we want to go. The game's kind of giving me a path now. I'm surprised. It sure didn't give me one before. Did I miss an obvious path? Is that what was going on with this? Okay, hop over here. Here, obviously, I want to get up on this. Actually, I think we probably want to get on the level below this, but we're up here now. Run along the pink wall. We want to go to the light. Don't go to the light, but it's so beautiful. Okay, there, there. All right, and we got waste up here on the right, just in case you didn't notice it. Cool looking world. Something like this would have been a big hit in the late 90s. The graphics would, you know, be pretty comparable to other games in its era. The lens flare would have been a big seller. It would have been like, dang son, we got us a lens flare. I'd be like, yeah. Said the Condor to the Praying Mantis, we're gonna lose this place just like we lost Atlantis. Brother, we gotta go, sooner than you know. The gypsy told my fortune. She said that nothing showed. Oh, that's a cheerful thing. Okay, well, let's keep running. Music's not really doing much for me. I mean, it's kind of cyberpunky and it fits, but it should make up its mind if it wants to be kind of quirky or like something Vangelis would come up with. Because right now it's doing neither of those very well. So we go this way. Maybe I should have got on the building all the way over there. You think I should have done that? I probably should have done that. Well, that arrow says to keep going this way. Okay. We'll follow the arrow. See what's over here. Unity engine lighting is so weird. Why are any of these lighting effects happening that are right in front of me? Okay, this was obviously not the right place to go. Okay. I guess we need to go back over here to this building and get on it. Maybe we need to get up higher. That's what we need to do. We need to get up on top, up to the top level of this thing. Like this. And then do a looking up jump to get up there. Yeah, there's the next node we gotta go to. It is pretty amazing that a single person can make a game like this, or, you know, a very small team of people. Unity allows, and other packages, I don't want to just call Unity out on its own, because there's lots of these things. They let people... I gotta go up that. Holy crab apple, I have to go up this thing. How these lighting shifts are killing me, though. Come on, just get me over here. Okay, land. Okay, I thought we were lined up to land on this thing, but guess not. Okay, whatever. Whatever, game. I saw. Now from that little ledge, let's boost up like this to here. Now from here, where do I go? Okay, get back to that little ledge. Climb this. That's awfully odd. Ow. Oh, do we make it up to another level? We did. Alright. Hey, what is that thing? Is that a pickup? Is that something I can grab? It probably is not. Now, we need to jump over there in just a second, but I gotta check this out first. Given how featureless everything is, because it's all just flat geometry. Yet another reason why this would have fit in the 90s. Flat geometry was all the rage in the 90s. I should play something from, like, circa 1999. Oh no, there's nothing here. It's just a light above a door. Okay. Yeah, let's get up on this roof. Cool. I can actually jump surprisingly high if I want to. I'm not sure the space being so big is really helping this game. Looks like we can just drop down to that building there. Yes, we can. Let's go over to the corner of this. That looks like where they meet. Let's jet over as far as we can in this direction. Boom! Nice. I have a feeling I'm supposed to jump off of something over there and land on this, and then continue my run, as opposed to going backwards. But, screw that. This was safe. I feel sad, but I feel happy, because I'm coming back to home. There's a bridge across the river that I have to cross alone, like a skipping rolling stone. Are these song lyrics? And I'm just somehow not familiar with them. I feel happy. Never mind. Don't want to get a copyright strike. Oh, this is a cool hallway to run down. This honestly would probably be better as a third-person game. The hallway we're running down. Yes, sir, that's one big hallway. Given how long this hallway is, we'd better be getting near the end of this game. Did I go the right way? I thought there was one of those yellow arrows back there that told me to turn left. I went left, and now we're just down this infinite hallway following a red line. The thin red line. Okay, nothing that way. Should I go this way? I bet it goes nowhere. I bet it does the same thing. There's just a wall up here. Oh! Oh, no, 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 no. Me no fall down. Me keep going this way. Oh my god, we're in a maze. Did this guy really design like a mile-wide maze? This is really kind of wasting, like, what the game's got going for it. And I'm already, losing interest in it because I've been running down this hallway chasing a red line for how long? Like, I guess this is the building I'm supposed to be in. But what is the point? Like, I'm supposed to go transmit a signal or something somewhere. Okay, so this is not the way I was supposed to be going, I guess. I don't know, I just thought I'd run in some direction and see what happened. And what happened was nothing happened. Oh my god, I need a map. I should have started drawing a map, I guess. But it's a first-person platforming game! Why on earth do I need a map? Okay. We are not somewhere I've been before. We are turned around. I'm gonna chance it and hope that this is the main path again. Yeah, no, yeah, no. I can't believe I almost fell down a pit. That's the opposite of what I want to do. I want to go up. Up, 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 up. Oh. Let's try this way. Yeah, featureless maze is not winning any points with me. Sir, not winning any points with me. Okay, I guess we'll go back this way. I don't know where I am. I am completely turned around and have no sense of my location. I broke the rules of the mazes. I wasn't following left-hand rule or right-hand rule. I was just going through a maze. That's a dead end. That's got a hitch in it, and then it goes down? I don't understand. See, I broke those rules again. Maybe I should go turn around. Okay, no, 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 no. We turn left here. I think I know where I'm at. We're gonna go back this way. And keep following around. We'll take the right up here. And that'll get us back to where we were. I just recognized that pit. So we've been that way. We have been that way. Oh. Apparently the answer is no, you have to go back that way. Okay. Okay, game. Fine. That's stupid. This is stupid. This maze is way too big. Like, I appreciate a proper sense of scale in my games, but come the freak on, man. So if I had to guess, I'd say this is the main path, and if I keep going straight, I'm going to leave the building. If I had to guess. And who knows, if we keep finding nowhere to go in here, we may end up leaving the building. Eliza Bar has left the building. Let's go this way, there's no light. Let's go that way, there's a light. At least is different. So if I go back and turn right, that gets me back where I came from. Okay. I feel like we're making progress now, though. That space was, you know, qualitatively different. It was a double wide hallway. So that suggests that it's the right way to go. just based on the fact that it was unique and different. But shouldn't I be going up instead of down? And here we go again with a... Oh, I'm going to sneeze. Hold on. Freaking winter and sneezing. All right, let's keep rolling here. Oh, look at that. Look at that. That's different. I think I see yellow. Do I see yellow? I think I see yellow. We found the way through this maze somehow. Thanks. Oh. I thought I was falling to my death or something there. I feel like this is where I'm supposed to go. Like, this is the end of the game. It said we're supposed to make it to the top of the spire, and we're not at the top of the building. Who put the bomb on the sacred altar? Why should we die? If it comes our way, why should we care about a little button being pushed by someone we don't even know? Alright, well, let's go this way now. Yellow. I guess we'll stay on the blue path. I see more yellow up there. That's obviously where we gotta go. And at least we're out of bland hallways with red lines. Even if we are just following a plain looking blue path thing now. Okay. Oh, great. Now we follow the blue line through bland hallways. Cool. Game. Are you guys enjoying this? I mean, is this even worth my time to play through at this point? Because it seems kind of endless. We solved a maze. Why are you giving me another maze? Nothing I can say through here. Yep. Hey guys, following the blue line. Hey guys, still following that blue line. Hey guys, there's a blue line here. We're gonna follow that for a while. Guys, hey, viewers at home, hi. We're following a blue line. Come on, yeah. I don't see where I need to go from here. Which is kind of a problem this game has a lot. It's just totally not obvious. Where on earth? Put the bomb on the sacred altar. You've already showed me that. Get rid of this text that's on my screen. This is stupid. Alright, I presume we're supposed to go this way, but I have no evidence to support that conclusion. Except for this text I can't get rid of on my screen. Man, in a lot of these indie games, I say something like, boy, I sure wish it was a full game. I think in this case, I'm kind of going, I wish this was shorter. Like, except for that early part, you know, I don't think the platforming has been a super big challenge. Maybe we're about to get to some more challenging platforming. But I honestly have no idea where I'm supposed to be going right now. Which is kind of the problem that I had at the beginning of the game, which is why it was such a challenge. Like, am I supposed to get up on this stuff? It looks like I should. But there's no, okay, I was about to say, but there's no thing telling me to go here. There it is. Alright, great. Well, this video is just going to keep going, I guess. Jesus. I was not expecting this game to be more than, like, 20 minutes long, and we're here at 36 minutes. Granted, that includes me being an idiot at the beginning and dying a couple times, but... I don't know. I don't know. Okay, I missed where I wanted to actually land, but we still landed somewhere safe, so I don't care. Just get over here. Alright. It still says that way, so I guess we keep going this way? I mean, this experience is wearing thin here. That and the weird graphical things are a problem. There's not enough here to sustain my interest as we go through. But I remember seeing those buildings before. We are really just running across this whole city, aren't we? And again, I don't know where I'm supposed to go. I'm supposed to go that way? How am I supposed to go that way? Okay, jump down on that thing over here, I guess. Maybe I should play Mirror's Edge. Maybe this is gonna help me. Oh, and this is to mark where that is? Uh-huh. That is a surprisingly useful graphical clue from a game that seemed kind of light on graphical clues. And I'm gonna sneeze again. Maybe. I don't know. Nope. It's, oh, it's just doing that thing. The thing that sneezes do when you don't actually sneeze, and they're just like, I'm gonna be in here annoying you, and it's like, irritation, and I'm dying, and that's really, I have nothing to talk about, so I'm talking about freaking sneezes, and not sneezing. Oh my god, this Let's Play has devolved this far. It's a shame. I mean, a lot of the stuff I'm looking around at is pretty cool looking. The colors chosen are all striking and stuff. I don't know, if I was developing this, I probably would have tried to go like full Tron or something with the way everything looked. Okay, we gotta keep going this way. Where we go after that, I don't know. Where do you go? Way across over here? Let's see, there's pink light there. Maybe that's where I gotta go. No, that's a reflection, isn't it? It keeps receding from me. Shoot. I'm supposed to jump to that thing. Which means I need to go up. Thank you. Okay. Just keep going this way, keep going this way, keep going this way. Get back on the ledge. Oh my god, I have to swing out and up. Faith from Mirror's Edge would be appalled! Oh my god, this is impossible. Oh my god! Oh, what happened? What happened? What happened? Is there another level that I can get to? Yes, there is. Oh, that. Oh, when you hit it. Oh, and it disorients you. Oh my god. Oh my god. Okay, let's just go. Go, go, go. Oh my god! Please make it! Oh! Okay. Let's just get up here. Oh, and there are more levels. I guess I was supposed to scale all the way to the top of that building? I guess so. Alright, so that says to keep going this way. Oh my god. Oh my god! I'm overheating here. I'm like all hopped up full of adrenaline. I know you're laughing. You're going, what a dork. There's my goal. I see the yellow of the node over there. Somewhere. It's probably like on the other side of the building. No, it's right there. Oh, we're almost there to the next node. Looks like I'll be able to just go over this way and jump from here straight up to there. Now for safety, there's a thing right there. All right. So let's just try it. Didn't quite make it. But we can jump off of this and go up there and make it. Yep. Gotcha. Gotcha, gotcha, gotcha. There it is. Can you guys have just put me like next to the spire and been like, your ultimate goal is the spire, so we have conveniently placed you next to the spire. I guess granted, you know, my task is to hack all these other nodes around town on the way to the spire for some reason. Why are you making me run so far between nodes? For a sense of realism? Jeez, this looks like it should be the last node. Look at this thing. If you want to get lost in the jungle rhythm, get down on the ground and pretend you're swimming. And once again, which way do I go? The game is so freaking opaque. As soon as I finish one place, it should tell me where I'm supposed to go next. And I'm just left guessing. Like, I'm gonna guess I should go maybe out this way and to the right, or I should have went straight through, or I have no idea. I honestly thought when the game put me in that maze, that maze was going to be the end of the game. You know, that was a new challenge I hadn't done before. I'm like, okay, that's probably it. Then, of course, the game did surprise me with that. You must leap off of the building, swing out around the edge, and then up. That's also a completely new challenge. worth going that way? I think we've made a circle. Weren't these buildings, like, straight ahead of me? Way back at the start? So we're, like, circling around. I wonder which one of these is the spire. I just want to go straight there. Hey, there's the waste. So we are moving through, like, a fully realized downtown area type thing. I mean, that in and of itself is pretty cool, I think. That it's just one big environment we're playing around in. Yeah, I guess we shouldn't have came out this way. We should have just stayed in the middle. That would have took us straight to this, which looks like where we need to go. I think having more obvious pathing would have been a very good thing for the development of this game. That's where we came from. Up. I guess I need to go up. Get up on that. Let's try it. Let's see if we can get over to this. Or not! Oh my god. Ah, freaky graphical glitches. Ooh, baby! Okay. Just kind of make the jump across, please. Make the jump across! Alright, are we high enough? Is this the level I need to be at to get across? Looks like it. Okay. It just would be really nice if there was some obvious indicator of this is kind of the general direction you need to go in. Because I'm just guessing that I need to go this way. That's the spire, isn't it? Holy crap. That has to be the spire. Oh my god, that is definitely the spire up ahead. So how am I going to get up it? Building? No, can't. Oh no, don't I have to walk like a tightrope type deal. Game, I'll save you the trouble. I will just surrender to you now. Oh my god. The things this game is making me do. It's just, it's not natural. It's not right. It's the kind of things you do to people you don't like, you know? It's like, you know. Oh, you know. Don't pretend you don't know, because you know. I know you know. You know that I know that you know, because we both know that you, in fact, know exactly what I'm talking about right here. Oh my god, the only way in I see is that little path over there. I don't want to do that. Look, they got like some kind of air battleship over there on the right. That blinks in and out of existence. It's got stealth field technology too. Oh my god, we're all doomed. One go. Maybe this path is better. I'm not sure I saw a way to get to that other building. Maybe I'm not actually supposed to go there. Maybe it's just for looks. And I'm actually supposed to go this way. And I can't believe we've been playing this game for 50 minutes now. I really should have cut this into two. I'm not going to, but I probably should have. Oh, no. It just has that same tiny little path to follow. Oh, my God. I don't want to do it. I don't want to do it. And if I die, I have to start like 10 minutes of jogging away. That's stupid. Oh my God, you made this environment too big, dude. Like, I get the, you know, realistic space and size arguments and stuff. I made the same complaint like when I was playing in Morrowind, and I'm like, you know, the description makes Vivek sound like it's supposed to be a much bigger city. And it's this canton, or set of cantons, where like 100 people live. It's like, this isn't even a city. This is a hotel. So that's kind of like the opposite of that complaint is going on here. I'm like, why is this so dang big? So much of this space is entirely and completely wasted. Like, I guess, granted, if this was, you know, you wanted to give somebody the realistic, you're a hacker fighting a dystopian society simulator while wearing a stealth-filled suit thing, 2016, this would be it, I guess, right here. Jetpack and stealth-filled simulator 2016, there we go. Looks like we go straight ahead. I'm lined up. Cool. We'll just go straight ahead. And we'll make it to the yellow building up here eventually. Oh. Where does that go? Nowhere. Okay. I'm just kind of guessing that that is the spire. I got nowhere else that looks nearly as interesting to go to, so that must be it. Have these people heard of fire escapes on buildings? They're a very handy safety feature that has been employed, you know, in buildings all over the world. Oh my God. Ah, down there. So I actually need to drop down to that crossbar thing I crossed over. Yeah, alright, so let's come back over here. I want to do it safely. I don't want to restart, like, from that checkpoint back there. That's like 10 freaking minutes away. Stay away from the edge. Alright, we gotta be getting close. Yeah, let's drop here. Down one level. Now let's double check. Good, it's safe. Let's drop. Now, let's come around this way. It's like you could have used the color yellow to indicate this is the path you want to take type stuff. Just by putting little yellow indicator lights or whatever scattered through, just be like, this is a good path. Oh my goodness. So now I need to start scaling this building. Yeah, I need to start scaling this building. We'll do it on this side, because there's no fall to my death if I mess up. Just like that. The bumping your head on something mechanic, I think is stupid. I understand why it's there, I just think it's stupid. It's there to represent that you just smacked your head into something while going 200 miles per hour straight up. Okay, yeah, I get it. That's fine. But, it disorients me, and this game is way, way too much about precision to have the player get disoriented like that. Alright, we're almost there. We're almost at the top of this thing. Come on! Oh my god, there's a checkpoint here. Thank god! Oh, thank you! Invisible flying spaceships. Can we just call this the top of the spire? My god, my hand is all sweaty. I've just been like clutching the mouse tightly this entire time. Why do we die? It comes our way. You want to get high, build a strong foundation. Sink those pylons deep now and reach for the sky. Oh! Okay. We're getting there. That glowy blue thing up at the top, that's probably my destination. This music is really annoying me, holy moly. Like, I've been listening to the same track, with variations on it, for 50 minutes now. 60 minutes almost. Oh my god, this video is Omega level long. 20 gigabytes in size, good lord, that's gonna take forever to upload. Jogging a mile across this thing. I've run out of topics to talk about. I mean, when I go to do my Spelunky video, you know, tonight, it's gonna be like, yep, and then I jumped, yep, and then I died to a snake, and then some spikes, and then spikes made of snakes. Oh my god, can I get up that? I think I can. Oh my god! Oh, thank goodness. But this isn't good enough, is it? Not good enough. There's no way up here. It's a solid ceiling. Maybe it's not so solid. Is that a crack in it? I totally don't understand the lighting and the way it's behaving. But we should check this out. This might be a better way to go up than trying to scale the outside of the building. Okay. I All right. Does this just end here? It should. That should be the other end of the building. Yeah, it is. All right, cool. Let's go this way. We'll try to adhere to some kind of rule, maybe. So this doesn't take 20 minutes to get through. But frankly, at this stage of the game, you should just be guiding me to where the end is, because we've already proven we can do a maze. We've already proven we can do everything you've thrown at us. Just make sure there wasn't like a hole in the ceiling. Okay. Wait, does that tick upward? Hold on, this looks like it goes up. If it does, this is where we need to go. I'm looking up and I'm trying to look for holes in the ground too. Yeah, this is exactly where we want to be. This is exactly where we want to be. Okay, land, thank you. Land, thank you. Okay, that's fine. Drop here. All right. Have these guys ever heard of lights before? There are these things, you install them, they provide lighting. I know it's kind of a strange and mysterious technology for evil cyberpunk overlords to use, but trust me, people love it. It will improve your ratings by several points. You will have to have fewer guards if you install lighting products. Purchase them now from Elizabar Incorporated. Elizabar City Pacification Lighting Technologies for over 50 years. Oh my god, we're up so freaking high. This reminds me of the outside of, like the Chantry or something in City of Heroes. Elizabar, does everything remind you of City of Heroes? Yeah, pretty much. I miss that game. Am I just supposed to be going up here? There's a blue light that way. That's the only reason I'm going this way. Alright, so it's like one of those follow the path lights, so let's follow it. It's also apparently like one pixel wide. Oh, my hand. My whole body's tense and stiff, I'm just like, I can't move. I was tempted to look down there, and then I stopped myself. Alright. That blue light led me in here, didn't it? Yeah. See, sometimes you're providing me really good context-specific, here's where you want to go stuff. And the rest of the time, you're just kind of leaving me on my own. It's so weird, game. Hey! Is that the hacky thing? Is this it? Do I hack this? Like, do I walk up in this thing? Okay, yellow! Great. I blinded myself. Let's walk back this way. chastised, blinded. Still seeing like yellow, like right up in my eyes. It's all that's there. It's the color yellow. Ow. Ow. Okay. We're on top. We're on top. We are on top. We made it. Alright, let's just... Do we follow the yellow? I guess we'll follow this yellow. That looks a little too high for me to scale with my jetpack. Maybe it's not. Maybe it's not. Should we try it? Oh my god. Oh, it worked. There we go. That's it. That's where we want to go. Oh, but that yellow goes to, like, a box or something? Hold on. Maybe that's where we need to go. Maybe that's what we hack. And that makes that thing work? I don't know. We'll keep following the yellow. I mean, we've been playing for an hour and some change. But that looks like where I want to go. So this had better be where I want to go, or I'm going to be mad. And I'm just lucky that that space battleship isn't shooting at me. I hate those space battleships, because they like to shoot at people. Maybe it's not a space battleship. Shut up, little voice. No, this went nowhere. That was a complete waste of all of my time. I guess that's like, just showing where power cables run or something? I don't understand it. I don't understand. I guess I don't really care either. Come on, I just wanna get over here to this thing. Let's go, game. I think the play space is a little too big for the amount of stuff in the play space. Like, if that makes any sense. Because these are big, empty spaces, and... In real life, there'd be... little air conditioning units, and... stuff. Just generically, there would be stuff all over the place. Ow. And that stuff is not in evidence here. Whew! Go! Oh my god, we're almost there. Quit jumping. Alright, go. If you look up while... If you look up while you're... Or press W while you're looking up. You, smack headfirst into things. No. There we go. You actually do like a little jump. It's kind of... It's odd. Said the Condor to the Praying Mantis. We're going to lose this place tonight. Brother, we got to go. Sooner than you know, the juice is on my fortune. Like an Inca. We win. I bet the game's going to close itself. So you're probably going to get interrupted in the middle of my closing thoughts, but... This was pretty fun. Those look like nuclear missiles. Click here for parting music. Let's record it for YouTube. It'll get flagged. Okay. Well, I guess I won't click there for parting music. I think we just blew up something and launched nuclear missiles. Maybe I was on the bad guy's side. I don't know. So that was certainly an interesting experience. I kind of got over my fear of heights while playing it. Maybe I'll play Mirror's Edge and then you can hear me scream and all the time. I don't know. That was fun. It was longer than I expected. How much of that was my own incompetence? I don't know. But those mazes where we were just kind of following lights and stuff, weren't that interesting. The big open spaces where I had no idea, like, okay, I should say no idea, places where I had no good guidance as to where I was going kind of sucked. I really appreciate that you didn't dump me, dump like, just quit out of the game right there. That's awesome, Connor Sherlock. And that's it. I'm going to shut up now. If you've watched this entire thing, thank you so much for watching 70 minutes of me derping around in this. Be sure to hit the like button, leave me some comments, and subscribe if you want to see more. Until next time, you have a great day. And after I get done talking to you, I'm going to listen to that parting music, unless recording for YouTube. See you next time.